Manscaped way, Riccardo Campello also arrived in time for the big swell tomorrow. Nevertheless, the conditions were perfect for towing, and so we kicked off with an absolute send fest. So freestyle stepped up to new heights as the freestyle foilers cut loose. Freestyle over, it was on to the foil racing. Let's head on over to Ben Proffitt for the full racing debrief.
So a quick roundup for day two of the IFCA Foil World Championships. Ned 55, who is he? Well, we know who he is now, yeah. Luke Van Opzilan at the top of the tree. He's over 2 meters tall and he is sitting there looking very good. Four races today, he had two bullets. But either side of that, had a couple of wobbles. In one race, he's actually in the protest room now, going for redress. So we'll have to have an update on them scores. But for whatever happens, he'll be still leading this world title race going into day three. Number two in the charts, who is it? It's the silver medalist from the Olympics in Beijing. Yeah, Julian Bontemps had a pretty consistent day, won the last race, and just by winning that last race, puts him just ahead of Gonzalo Costa Hovel. Obviously, Costa Hovel sitting in third place now. Had probably the best day out of everyone. I think he had a couple of second places. He won the first race. He was looking very consistent, looks on top form. He's won this race here before three times. I think he's won every foil race here in silver planner. So he is coming on strong and the boys are going to have to watch out. Got to mention the old boy, yeah, Steve Allen. He's still there, just 1 point off third place. Let it slip in the last race. He was right up there, but another consistent day for him, and he is looking good. We've got to give a special shout out to Nicholas Goya. He had an awesome day today. He nearly won the third race. It came down to a close finish, him and Opzilan going down the last race, but in the end, he just couldn't hang on to it and went in the drink. Managed to get up and survive in third, but he had a couple of wobbles as well, but he's right up there in the rankings. What else did we see today? I've got to mention this, Steven van Brockhoven. The wind swung in the last race and it made the start line really square. Up until then, we'd had like a port tack bias line, so everyone went off on port, he went off on starboard, and it just looked carnage. We were in the live booth just cringing, thinking, is he gonna make it? But he's been doing well for a freestyler and he's looking good. So there we go, 9 races all in all. That's a little bit of rundown. All the results are online, you can check them out. And that's it, day three coming up tomorrow. Forecast looks pretty good. And don't forget, we have got the marathon tomorrow. 150 competitors, kites, sailors, we've got everyone thrown in. It's gonna be pretty epic.